Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. This is the sixth video on logging. In this video, we'll see how to schedule the script execution and continuously monitor the device. In the previous video, we have seen how to trigger email from Python script for the log events. But this execution happens only once. Now, if you want to schedule it and run continuously and monitor the device, we will use another Python library called schedule. Let's have a look into that. So you can see here, this will help you to schedule the task, but this module will not be available by default in Python, so you have to install it. In pycharm, what you have to do is go to the settings and Python interpreter, and you can just add it here. You can just add the project here by clicking the plus button, and you can see I have already installed it, the schedule. Otherwise, in terminal you can do the pip install schedule. Once you install it, we'll import the module here, and if you see the syntax, we need to define this as a function, and then we just need to do a while loop, and the schedule options you can see here. You can even schedule every 10 seconds or every 10th minute, and every hour, every day at 10:30 a.m. or every 5 to 10 minutes, every Monday, and a lot of combinations are there. We'll see every minute at and every 10 seconds. Now, first thing what we need to do is we need to define this as a function. I have tried using my existing function, but that was not working. So we'll define another function here on top of it. We'll define this as parser, and the complete command execution I'll put under that parser. So you can see here now, if I execute this parser script, the complete script will get executed. Let us try running it. So there is a parsing error. I'll be receiving an email as well. You can see this. The time is 7:08. Now let us go to the documentation. Okay, after defining the function, what we need to do is we need to define the schedule. So let us schedule the job. It will every 15 seconds I'll give, and in our case the job name is parser. And one thing you need to be careful is you don't need parentheses here, but by default pycharm is adding it. And then we'll create a loop while true, then schedule dot run pending, and as per the syntax itself we can give time dot sleep if you need one. You can see the syntax here. Now let us try running the script again. Now it should run at every 15th second. So you can see here, it ran at 7:10. And again it is running. So it is running at 15th second. If you see the log here, even here also you should be able to see. Let us verify the email also. Yeah, I'm getting email as well here. Now let me just stop the script. And I'll give the correct command here. So here also you can see it is logging the message. So now it is a script execution is successful. Now let's see the second execution. But here in this case we need to always keep a terminal open, and if you open run it from this terminal as well, you should keep the terminal open for running the script. But now script is capable of monitoring the device and triggering email if any syslog event occurs. Now we'll see how to run this in the background for the Linux operating system so that it can continuously monitor. So in the next video we'll see how to use the nohop option in Linux for executing this in the backend. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.